Hello viewers, my name is Florence Minor, welcoming you to yet another time of Celebrate Your Moment this Sunday afternoon. I want to believe that you went to the house of God and you're blessed. And if you did not go, I'm going to remind you again that next Sunday, make a time to go to the house of God. Can you imagine 6 days you've been into your business and God has given you all the strength and the health to do it? It's good that you go to the house of God and try to evaluate what you have done and be grateful for it. Even God himself created the world in 6 days and he had a time to rest so that he could look back and say, surely everything was very good. Today I went for prayer meeting in my home church, and while we were there, I learned that we are about to start a series as a church about prayer. And while we were taking turns praying, the Spirit of God quickened me on the parable that Jesus gave in Luke 18 about that widow who went to the judge asking for her case to be avenged. And though this judge did not fear God or regard any man, because of this woman who kept on nagging him, according to him anyway, he ended up granting her request because he did not want to be bothered anymore. And I'm just going to read verse 1, and I would like you to read the entire part of it. It says, "Then he spoke a parable to his disciples that men ought always to pray and not lose heart." I'm going to title my message, "Persistence in Prayer Pays." No man has ever persisted in prayer and failed. And so, as you persist in prayer without giving up, you are going to get your reward. If you persist in prayer, you'll be able to enjoy the fruit of your labor. If you persist in prayer, you'll be the head and not the tail in whatever you do. If you persist in prayer, you'll be able to save your marriage. If you persist in prayer, your children will be protected day in and day out. If you persist in prayer, even when the storms of life comes your way, you'll enjoy peace in the midst of the storm, because you know you are involving the one who calms the stormy sea. Persistence in prayer will always pay. And later on, I went to for an anniversary celebration of one of the Kenyan church that was celebrating 13 years. And I was so much blessed as Reverend Gero was giving the story of how the church started. And you know, I'm a very keen person to small things, and as he was speaking, I could pick up some words about persistence and not giving up, because there have been, of course, there are times that things seems like it's a desert, things seems hard, people can come and go, but because this is a church of God, this is the body of Christ, it cannot die. And so he was talking about four things about the church, and one of the things I pick is organism, because organism is something that always grows, it's not stagnant. So yeah, even as you persist in prayer, know that whatever you are persisting for, it is growing. Every time you pray, you are putting something to growth, and it's going to mature, and you're going to harvest when you get the results. So may the Lord bless you. Let us continue to share this word to encourage many. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, help us to persist in prayer without giving up. Even when things don't seem like they are working the way we would want, let us not lose hope. Let us not give up. And for those who have not given their life to thee, O God, how I pray that they may have a hunger and a thirst for you, O Father, that they can say, "I surrender to you," in Jesus' name. May the Lord bless you. Again, our text of reference today was Luke 18. Read the entire chapter, but I concentrated on verse 1. Thank you.